A few years ago, I attended a conference. The woman was presenting the research she had gathered over 3 years of research, studying the correlation between joblessness and the rate of prostitution and pimps. I had never thought about the joblessness rate leading to vulnerability and people being marginalized. St. Louis, North City, has an incredibly high rate of joblessness and an incredibly vulnerable people group living there because it's so difficult to get employment. Shortly thereafter, I was introduced to a center that's working with young men in North City, teaching them about integrity, teaching them about leadership, teaching them about business, while they are in a program to learn how to screen print and therefore learning how to be employed. They also provide jobs for these young men, and that's where we get most of our t-shirts screen printed. So we were able to step in, provide dignified employment for young men living in an area that has this incredibly high rate of joblessness and therefore are vulnerable to other opportunities that could lead them into an area where they could become a pimp, or they could be exploited themselves. So that's one example of the impact we're making through our partnerships in marginalized people groups. Another is also in St. Louis, and it's a group of refugees and immigrants. We have all heard about the difficulties and the issues and the migration that's happening around the world because of war and because of different situations that our world is seeing today. Refugees and immigrants don't speak the language. They have a hard time getting jobs. How are they going to support themselves in a new country? They're fleeing for their lives. They land in a wonderful country, but they don't speak the language. They can't get a job. How are they going to feed their families? This center in St. Louis is working with ladies coming from other countries, providing them with the skills they need to have a job sewing and making jewelry. These women are able to stay at home, do the pieces that they're working on, stay with their children. It keeps them from having to pay childcare, provides income for them, and provides that dignity and that ability to create income for their family. So whether it's working with young men in a jobless area, whether it's refugees and immigrants that would otherwise not be able to get a job, or single mothers in Haiti, or single mothers in China, or single mothers in Ghana, working with women and men that are in marginalized situations and otherwise vulnerable to exploitation because of their situation, we are providing dignified employment, and that is the impact that we're seeing in multiple countries around the world because we focus on marginalization as well.